Currently, for efficient data management are used databases. A database is a shared integrated computer structure that stores a collection of data. There are two main types of data stored in a database: end-user data and metadata. The end-user data consists in raw facts introduced and managed by the end-user. The metadata, named also data about data, provides a description of data characteristics, like the type of the value stored, numbers, dates or text, and also relationship between data, like the relationship between a student and the class in which is enrolled. While the database gives a structure to keep the data, we also need programs to process the data. The collection of all programs used to manage the database structure and to allow and control access to the data stored in the database is named Database Management System, DBMS. The Database Management System is an intermediary between the database and the end users. One or more end users access the database through the Database Management System. The access may be done from a local computer or by internet. The Database Management System hides the specific way in which the data is stored on a permanent memory like the hard drive. It allows the user to have a single integrated view of the data. A database management system helps to make data management more efficient and effective. We'll discuss now the main advantages of a database management system. It allows the users to share the data, many users using the same data in the same time. It controls who and what access. Having many users accessing the same data, you want to be sure that they will not be able to modify or read information unneeded. A database management system will enforce data privacy and security policies. It also creates a global integrated view of the company operations. Another important characteristic is that it minimizes data inconsistency. But what is data inconsistency? Imagine that you have two files. In one, your telephone number is your current phone, but in another one is a former phone number that was not updated when you change your phone number. In this case, the database will contain inconsistent data. A database management system has tools that allow a good database design to avoid data inconsistencies. Another novel characteristic of database management system is that the processing of the data is not done directly accessing the data files and processing them through one of the third generation programming language, Fortran or COBOL. Instead, it uses a query language. In such a query language, which is a fourth generation programming language, you just specify what need to be done and the system will decide how to do it. So you place a query, a request, and the system will return a result named query result set. Such an interaction allows creating on-the-run questions as they are needed, without having to modify the application programs that are managing the database. All these advantages will improve the decision-making process and will increase the productivity of the end user. Databases can be classified based on various criteria. The number of users allowed to access the database in the same time, the location in which the data is stored, and based on the expected type and extent of the use of the database. Based on the number of users, we have single-user databases and multi-user databases. A single-user database supports only one user at a given time. It is also named a desktop database because it is usually located on the user computer. A multi-user database supports multiple users to access the database in the same time. If fewer than 50 users have access to the database, it is also called a workgroup database. If hundreds of users from the entire organization access the database, it is called an enterprise database. Based on the database location, we have centralized and distributed databases. In a centralized database, all the data is physically located, saved at a single site. In a distributed database, the data is distributed, saved at different sites. Based on the role of the database, its expected type, and for what is used, we have operational databases and data warehouses. A database built for an organization's day-to-day operations is named operational database or transaction database or production database. If the database is built as an archive to store data to be used for tactical or strategic decisions, then it's named data warehouse. This classification has a significant effect on the organization and processing of the database. More recently, another classification criteria was introduced based on the degree of structuring the data. A text in plain English is an unstructured document because you need to understand English in order to process the data within the document. On the opposite side, if you have a table with data, for instance, the grades and names of the students in the class, you have a structured document. In between, there is semi-structured data. For instance, an XML document contains both plain text but also a hierarchical organization set of text that are organizing and specify the meaning of the text. Most of the modern database management systems support all the types of databases.